Hey there guys, it's me, Stephanie, and today I'm going to make a movie review about the film we watched, The Last Emperor. So The Last Emperor is a historical epic film released in 1987. It was directed by Mr. Bernardo Bertolucci, and it is based from the autobiography of Emperor Puyi, the last emperor of Qing Dynasty in China. The movie garnered 9 Academy Awards, including that for Best Picture. So did you know that it was the first featured film permitted to be filmed inside the Forbidden City?
Sure.
The movie begins in 1950 with the arrival of Puyi at a prison in China, where he attempts suicide but is survived by the prison governor. The story then unfolds as a series of flashbacks intercut with scenes of Puyi's re-education. In 1908, at the age of 3, Puyi is summoned to the Forbidden City by the Empress Dowager, who declares him as the Emperor.
Sure.
By the time Puyi is 8 years old, he has gotten used to court life. His family arrives and though he no longer remembers them, his 7-year-old brother, Pu Chie, remains in the Forbidden City to be a playmate and companion to the Emperor.
Sure.
After a revolution overthrows the Qing Dynasty, Puyi learns that he is the emperor only of the Forbidden City. Outside of those walls, China is now a republic. In 1919, the Scotsman Reginald F. Johnston becomes the tutor of Puyi, and he provides Puyi with the information about the world outside the Forbidden City. Mr. Johnston gave Puyi a bicycle on which Puyi used when he attempted to escape the grounds. In 1922, a wife, Wan Jung, was chosen for Puyi, and he also takes a secondary wife who is named Wen Shu.
Sure.
In 1924, Puyi and all the other occupants are ordered to leave the Forbidden City. He and his wives take up residence in the Japanese pre-occupied area within Tianjin.
Sure.
Puyi travels to the Japanese puppet state of Manchukuo in Manchuria. In 1934, he became the emperor of that state.
Sure.
In 1945, after the fall of Japan in World War II, Puyi is captured by Russian troops. While Puyi is in the prison, Puyi learns for the first time in his life to take care of his own personal needs, and he renounces his cooperation with the Japanese.
Sure.
In 1959, he was released and he becomes a gardener. Later in 1967, during the Cultural Revolution, he sees a parade in which the former prison governor who helped him with his rehabilitation is being humiliated as an enemy of the revolution. In the final scenes, Puyi visits the Forbidden City as a tourist, and 20 years later, a tour guide leads American tourists into the palace throne room.
Sure.
For me, the actors and actresses were good. They did a job well done. The lightings and the soundtrack of the movie were also great. Bertolucci showed the amazing appearance of the Forbidden City. Bertolucci also used astonishing use of location, authentic costumes, and thousands of extra to make the life of Puyi realistic. The movie also showed the culture and traditions of China. That's why I recommend you guys to watch this movie, especially to those who love watching movies about histories. And that's all for my movie review. Thank you for watching. Bye!